Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome. I don't know how many Silorum graduations I've been to, but it is an extraordinary comment on the vitality and of Heart of Life and its missionary spirit. When it started, I think it was largely a Caucasian, Anglo-Saxon, Irish, maybe a few even Dutch people coming, but now it's from all over the world, literally, and we have had some people from the United Kingdom doing it, but that is an extraordinary achievement and fits in very well with that missionary emphasis of the MSC founder, Jules Chevalier, you know, may the sacred heart of Jesus be everywhere loved. And today we talk about taking to the world the compassion, the love and the mercy of Jesus Christ, and so wonderfully promoted by Pope Francis. So welcome, and pay a little bit of respect to the Aboriginal people whose land this used to be, and their respect for them, their elders, go back thousands and thousands of years. So once again, welcome.
Earlier this year, I was gifted with a book called Phosphorescence. Some of you might have read it. And it was written by Julia Baird and reflects her experience of going through dark times, darkest times in her life. And she took as her image that of phosphorescence, who are little sea creatures who give off sparks of light in the depths of the ocean. And in this year, a year like no other, we have all continued to dive deep in our Silorum journey, staff and students alike, to experience the losses and the disappointments, the weariness, and to treasure the sparks of light. We've learned to make the most of every experience, to come face to face with our own powerlessness, vulnerability, and the humility of what really means to listen contemplatively, to wait in the silence for the spark of illumination. As I was reflecting on this, I was remembering and sharing with Paul today when he told us we'd be on Zoom. Go home, you'll be on Zoom. I thought my life was over. Anyway, I'm still here. And we became dependent on the Zoom link. And I have to confess, I had many nights of waking up thinking, I've missed the link. I can't find the link. And then I'd realise, yes, I have got the link. So I'm gathering you'd all have that feeling of we haven't got the link. But in a way, we've found the link at a deeper level, in that contemplative, deep listening to one another, that precious gift. So we take time to remember those who have helped us keep in the loop and helped us to keep being linked to one another. Staff and supervisors and families and friends and communities. All those people like directees who've come along to walk with you and people who've done retreats with you. And they're all part of the holy ground of your experience. And part of that is that sense of the divine presence, which I know has been there with all of you. And you've expressed it in so many ways, that links us together. And it's beautifully depicted on the booklet, that beautiful image The Spirit of God is upon me. The shadow of God's presence upon us. The spark of light in our midst. And so just for a few moments, we're going to have a little look at the spark of light in you.
Is full of words, isn't it? And there's a lovely song in My Fair Lady that talks about there's too many words. So tonight, beyond words, our spiritual directors are going to offer you the symbol of their call and their mission that they've felt over these 2 years for the part-timers and 1 year for the full-timers. So we'll begin with full-timers. They'll speak about their symbol and then place it around here, and then the part-timers will take it off. So who'd like to start? What about you, Gemma? Don't you like getting dobbed in?
My symbol is a cup and saucer. They go together. Just like a director and directee. The cup can be full, it can be empty, it can be half full. The saucer can stay underneath and hold the cup, or it can stay on top to keep the content warm. But the saucer can also block the content. Coming in or out. God is present in this cup and saucer for me, just as God has been present throughout this year.
Jesus' resurrection. And it's the experience of death or emptying myself and filling with new hope. For me, I believe that the Lord has given me this grace to easily experience this so that I continue to be able by the power of love by emptying myself. I may be free from shame and guilt and be with my other person with God's love. And I'm very grateful for His unconditional love.
Thank you. beginning of the program, the invitation was to be in the pool of Siloam with Jesus for ongoing healing and transformation. Towards the end of the program, it was kind of revealed to me that my heart is the pool of Siloam, where Jesus stands with me as I dig myself into the pool of Earth's pains and joys for ongoing healing and transformation. I am grateful for the Spirit of God for opening my heart, learning in the end, and I hope when the heart is open, the Spirit can breathe. So I pray that my heart will always be open to welcome whoever will come to me to foster a relationship.
Over 10 years ago, this icon came to live with me and my family, and I didn't quite understand what it meant until now. It came to my favourite.
My symbol is the icon of tender mercy of God. It is the icon that I wrote. And Mother Mary, for me, is the person who surrendered all to God. Not what she had, but who she was. She trusted God, waited patiently, and discerned the will of God. Only God and grace was enough for her. In my Siloam journey, I was challenged to surrender, wait patiently, and discern the will of God in order to receive the grace of tender mercy. I'm grateful for the gift of mercy.
My symbol is a glass of water. May I be like life-giving water to my directee who seeks spiritual help and guidance. Like water takes different shapes and forms in different circumstances and environment, let me adjust myself to the situations of my directee I meet. As water remains stagnant and never force itself, may I remain calm and serene in all circumstances of my life. Lord, you are the source of living water. Fill me with your life-giving spirit and make me fresh and strong. May I experience your providential care every day of my life. Fill me, Lord, with your love and refresh me with your spirit. Help me always to live in your presence and help me to share your love with others. May I be a life-giving water to others.
I took this symbol from the trip of two of Jesus' disciples to Emmaus. At the time Jesus appeared and walked among them. This reminded me about the first, at the beginning of the journey, it is with Emmaus' heart of life. I have no idea what is his spiritual direction is. Even as a definition, as with the grace, the companionship of Jesus, I came to define spiritual direction as an act of guiding the soul and directing oneself towards inner peace of heart in the presence of God's grace in companionship by walking side by side. I am grateful for his journey and grateful for his companionship.
I brought a heart,
broken, and I'm grateful for a broken heart in the world and in my own self. And with the love of God, it's been a journey of healing and love. So that's what Silly One has been for me.
The journey of Silly One for me has been a journey of transformation and a journey of healing. I became like a pine cone, which is who I always felt I was. A young pine cone who didn't really get to ripe and give fruit, the beautiful fruit that's inside. There was a bit of a stuckness in there. But when I came to Siloam, that pine cone was submerged in the Siloam waters and gradually got moistened and was able to open up, become supple. And this is what I find God has given me. Through everyone in Siloam, I've become a water lily with so many petals and so many shades and possibilities. And the love and compassion that I've received at Siloam is what I pray to God that I'll be able to give others in the ministry of spiritual direction.
The symbol I have chosen is a bamboo. It's not really a bamboo, but set of bamboos. So the introduction says, heart of life, graduation day, but nonetheless it's a beginning of a new and more challenging journey. If you realize, the three roses are there, Maria, Lydia, and Sue. Let us pass us. I could not just go on in my journey. I have not gone in my journey without these three precious jewels in and of course, our beloved supervisors also, Carol and Marlin, they are part of the journey. And also the Sinua as a group, the professors and people are part of the journey, which I also love from them. Okay, so the symbol of bamboo is strength, resistance, sturdiness. Symbol of power, stamina. Also a symbol of being flexible. Symbol of getting along with the movement of the wind. Its usefulness happens when it will be cut off for some purpose. That's the reason if we become truly what we are, as spiritual directors, we become when we empty ourselves, when we become off from being what we are, and become really at the disposal of our directives. Siloam, an instrument of making some foundations. Roots and base, that's why Siloam is here, part of the foundation. A vehicle for knowledge, an avenue for self-awareness, introspection, etc. A place of interaction, community-mindedness, etc. Gospel values in the right corner. A roadmap of one's life is set, foundation of truly living as Christians. Jesus, the aspect of self-emptying, the way, self-surrender, and self-sacrifice.
I chose a stream as my symbol for what Siloam means to me and what I want to be for other people, to be able to move with them. As they make their journey, that I may also allow the Spirit of God to simply flow within me and take me where God wants to take me on my journey, but to be that companion for other people on their spiritual journey. And of course, the beautiful story of the woman at the well, the Samaritan woman at the well, the water of life, that I yearn for that water of life, that is God for me.
Can I share why I wrote it?
Yes, go for it. I'd like to share why I wrote it, because having been blessed, like all of us here, to learn so much in Siloam, one of the parts of Siloam this year that really moved me and really I experienced a deep transformation because of, was within the realms of echo spirituality. And it really broke me open. And so this song was inspired by the learning that I received during that part of the course. And this song is my way of saying thank you, but it's also my way of saying that that the Spirit has really moved me very deeply in this part of my life. So the song is called In My Father's House, In My Mother's House. In a world where time is money, on our streets there are the poor. In your image we're born equal, but then why do I have more? In a world no longer silent, I can't hear my neighbors cry. In a world that's only virtual, I can't look into your eyes. But in my Father's house, there are many rooms to rest our weary head. And in my mother's house, in her sacred womb, we are nourished, we are fed. In a world cries our river with the rain, as we kill our very life source, and our planet cries in pain. In a world so full of strangers, where our neighbors die alone, on the door the sign says danger, you're not welcome in our home. But in my Father's we are.
Spirit leading from all the Philippians. I thank my God every time I remember you, constantly praying with joy in every one of my prayers for all of you. Because of your sharing the gospel from the first day until now, I am confident of this, that the one who began the good work among you will bring it to completion by the day of Jesus Christ. And this is my prayer, that your love may overflow more and more with knowledge and full insight to help you to determine what is best. I'll now call forth each of the graduates, and when I call your name, just come and line up here, please. Sue McGovern. Lydia Rovira Finch. Vito Dulles. Agostino Esposto. Theodora, Dora Yahadis. Anila Isaac. Projects are ready. I'm already. Soji Mati. Gemma, please. Gemma Schoenberg. And if the supervisors aren't here, please come and we'll distribute the certificates to the graduates. So when I call your name again, please come over and receive your certificate from Heart of Life. Maria, you're the closest. Thank you. Go on. Sue got it. Lydia. Vito. Esposto. Oh. Nora. Suji. I'll ask you to read the graduate's prayer.
The Gospel is from Luke, chapter 4, verse 14 to 19. Then Jesus, filled with the power of the Spirit, returned to Galilee, and a report about him spread through all the surrounding country. He began to teach in the synagogues and was praised by everyone. When he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, he went to the synagogue on the Sabbath day, as was his custom. He stood up to read, and the scroll of the prophet Isaiah was given to him. He unrolled the scroll and found the place where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim release to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favour."
Each of us
like to make two very brief comments that reflect part of life. If you take the reading that Robin read for us, that Jesus gave in the synagogue in Nazareth, and go back to the original in Isaiah, Jesus was very naughty. He left out a line. He didn't say he'd come to preach a day of vengeance for the Lord. He wiped that out of his commission. And that reflects us too. It reflects the compassion of heart of life. I'd also like to quote the great Irish poet Oscar Wilde, who was a bit naughty and he got sent to jail. And he wrote a beautiful poem called The Ballad of Reading Jail. And Sue, you reminded me of it, about a broken heart, because he said, "For only through a broken heart may the Lord Christ enter in." And so let's look up rather than bow our head. Let's look up. Even though my geography was challenged once by somebody saying that, just look up to the good Lord, and we'll say, "The Lord be with you." Amen. May Almighty God bless us all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let's go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Amen.
This is one of those, excuse me, very rare occasions in my life when I have the final word. At work, at family, it's a rare privilege. And so it comes to this. In conclusion, I can say to the 11 people in front of us, you are now spiritual directors and graduates of the Siloam program at the Heart of Life Center for Spiritual and Pastoral Formation. As you're aware, the program takes its name after an incident in John's Gospel, Chapter 9, where a blind person is brought to Jesus by his disciples to be healed. Jesus makes a paste with his spittle, rubs it in the blind man's eyes, and then he sends him to the pool of Siloam to wash, which he does, and his eyes are opened and he can see. John points out that the name Siloam means sent. While one may be immediately aware of a similarity to the blind man's experience and what occurs in the Siloam program, I have no intention of entering into a exegetical analysis of John chapter 9. It's getting much too close to dinner to do that. I'll conclude with this liturgy by saying some names. Maria, Lydia, Sue, Rowan, Gemma, Dora, Anila, Soji, Avito, Esposto, and Raja. We send you forth, confident that you will listen with all your heart, mind, and soul to the people who are led to you. People who see themselves through a glass darkly. And with the assistance of the Holy Spirit, you will awaken them to the beauty and the truth that lies within. This is your vocation now, your calling. We old-timers rejoice to send you to where you are needed most. Always remembering that you're part of our family now. The family of Heart of Life. Wherever we are is your home. I'm going to say goodbye to you in a beautiful farewell in Korean. You probably have heard me say this before. The words are, when you go, I say, Annyeonghi gaseyo. And you say to me, Annyeonghi gaseyo. Translated, it is, please go in peace. And your response is, please stay in peace. And I'll use the higher language to say this, Annyeonghi gaseyo. Maria.
Silence your embrace, heart of life, in love we call.
may or may not know this, but this person is not only not coming to dinner tonight, but this is his final time with us after a number of years. And he's done a magnificent job, way beyond what we asked. When he told me he was going, I was shocked, and then tried all kinds of dirty tricks to get him to stay. But he's been a great friend, and he will continue to be. So, Simon, please. Simon, thanks. Thank you.
Thank you, Paul.
These are chocolates.
He knows I'm a chocolate.
Thanks for all you did. I won't go on, but you've just been fantastic.
Thank you, Paul. I really appreciate it.
Big round for you. The only thing left to do before we go over to Georgios is someone else can't be there tonight with us, and you would know how hard she works, and I'm going to get into real trouble for Moon's telling you, but Sue's been an absolutely have happened without her and Cecilia as well. Mm-hmm. Cecilia would be fantastic. Yeah. And she's a really good mother, and how can you combine all of that together in one bundle of joy for us? Thanks for what we see you soon. Thanks for that. It's very good time to talk to the company, to be honest. And let's go over. You've heard about it?
Yeah.
Thank you all.